The annual Hoagland Days Festival will take place next weekend.
And it's been around for a while, over half a century. Some family-friendly activities and contests will be back once again. That's just part of the fun. Here with us this morning is Heather Anderson, and Danelle Westrick. The rain has me... I'm thinking about weather. Good morning. Thanks for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having
Hopefully
us.
The weather's better for Hoagland Days next weekend.
We
right?
hope. Yeah.
Yeah, so this has been going on for, you said, 51 years,
yes.
You told me, in between commercial breaks. Talk about how this has evolved over the years.
We'll let you go ahead and to you.
Well, it started just as a small town festival with farm animals and a few kiddie rides and games, and it's expanded into a full-fledged festival with amusement rides and parade and adult beverage tent,
yeah,
demo derby.
You know, people will like that. Now you were telling us that you've been involved for a large chunk of that, right? Talk a little bit about your history with it.
Well, my father was treasurer of the Hoagland area for 37 years, so I've been involved for many, many years. I've chaired the Hoagland Days. We have expanded it, as I said, getting amusement rides instead of just blow-up jumpy. Mm-hmm. We have entertainment.
Yeah, there you go. This year's theme is Small Town USA. What made you come up with that?
Hoagland is a small town, obviously.
Of course.
We support our own. All the money from Hoagland Days goes back to the community for sidewalks, to supporting the park, the baseball leagues. It's
the pavilion. We've remodeled the kitchen.
Oh, yeah. Great. So it's a fundraiser for Hoagland.
Correct. Yes. So all the money stays back in the community.
Well, it's great that you're able to benefit the people who are also enjoying it then.
Yes.
Now, what are some of the challenges that come along with putting this all together and some of the benefits as well?
The weather.
Yeah. Come on, Rob.
Supposed to be putting tents up today.
Yeah.
But getting volunteers. But we don't have a whole lot of problem with that usually.
Yeah. How many volunteers do you guys usually work with to pull the event off?
Oh, my. Probably 100, 150. I mean, everywhere you look, there's a volunteer.
Wow.
Everybody who has a booth in the food is a volunteer.
Yeah. Our food court is all for non-for-profit. So you can come in to eat at the food court. It stays in the community. You got the band, the churches. Everybody's there.
That's great. Yeah. Now, the parade is a big part of this festival, and you mentioned that there's some changes this year. Can you talk a little bit about that?
This year, we added ATVs. We're decorating our ATVs and our golf carts this year to go along with our theme, Small Town USA. We started it this past Christmas. Everybody came, decorated their ATVs, and then we had a parade. So now we're doing it. We're adding it up. We're decorating it, and they're coming back, and we're doing like a car show with it after the parade. So come out, watch
and judge the golf carts.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Sounds like a fun time.
Thank you so much. Yeah. We'll hope for better weather.
It sounds like it's supposed to be.
It should be better. We're going to hope for that. If you want to check out Hoagland Days, this year it's going to take place June 14th through 16th at Hoagland Community Park. You can find a detailed schedule of all of the events at hoaglandin.com and on our website, wayne.com.